9 months ago, I've started to learn Unity. But actually, I should start my story a bit earlier. About a year ago, a crazy idea came into my mind. What if I could make a game? I'm a huge fan of the Final Fantasy franchise, so I thought about some story-driven JRPG, and even had a story in mind, but very quickly I've realized that if I want to make the next Final Fantasy, I need to be the next Square Enix. And obviously, I'm not even close. I don't have all the resources that Square Enix have. Even worse, I've never made any games. So, should I give up? No. Well, Final Fantasy-like project is too ambitious for a beginner, that's for sure. So I thought, what game can I make anyway? I like stories, and I like anime, so I can try working in that direction. I told this to my boyfriend, Dennis, and this is how the idea of Fruits Against Vegetables was born. So, Dennis and I decided to make a game together. He'll be writing the story, and I will code. We've decided on a 2D platformer because it seemed to be the best option for a beginner, and jump right in. While Dennis was working on the plot of the game, I've started to build a game prototype in Unity. I've had to learn a lot of things because I wasn't familiar with Unity at all, but at least I know a little Java from college, and since Java is very similar to C#, I could start coding right away. At the very beginning, the game looked like this. I didn't have any art, but I just wanted to start somewhere, so I've created these simple shapes in paint and made them move in Unity. Well, it was a challenge trying to explain everyone that this orange circle is actually a stubborn tangerine girl, and those other things are the evil vegetables trying to kill her. It's not that obvious after all, I've had to get some art. My Photoshop skills were pretty much zero, so I've hired a freelance artist to draw the characters for me. She's done it way better than I could have ever done myself. At the meantime, I fixed some weird bugs, and once the first batch of art was ready, I thought that I can quickly learn how to animate the characters and make the game look awesome. Well, creating animations for a game was clearly not a quick task for a complete beginner. Looking back, I think I should have asked for help, but at least I've learned a lot of things and totally fell in love with the animation process. At some point, I've realized that it's not about creating them fast anymore. It is about making those animations look as good as I possibly can and creating something that I will be proud of. And finally, I've had enough assets to start replacing the old art with the new one, making the game look better and better and better. Now the game looks somewhat close to what I've had in my mind at the very beginning. I've tried to make it look cartoony, and it seems like I'm getting closer to that. I didn't finish the game yet, and there are still a lot of things to learn. Right now, I'm working on the first 5 levels only, and they're going to be the game demo. The game is evolving into something much bigger than it was at the beginning, and Dennis has a lot of ideas, and I wish I had the time to implement all of them. What I know for sure is that this project is one of the most exciting things that I've ever done in my life, and it feels so right that I wish I've started it earlier. I'm trying to post a new video update every week, so if you want to become a part of this journey and watch my progress, you can do it here on my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you next week.